All right, welcome. This is Jamie Oikle from runningrestaurants.com, where we bring you the tips, tools, and techniques you need to make your restaurant more profitable and successful. We've got a great session on tap for you today, all about restaurant marketing and driving more business into your restaurant. Joining me to talk all about this is friend and colleague Dyson Barnett of Fan Connect. Welcome, Dyson. How are you, buddy?
Hey, man, I'm doing great. Yourself?
I'm doing good, doing good. I'm excited about this. I am, much like yourself, passionate about marketing topics, so I love this stuff. But this is in your wheelhouse, so I'm going to let you take it away, take control of the presentation. I'm going to look for opportunities to add on or poke in for questions, and so let's go for it. Let's dig in. I think you should be able to take the screen. Let's see.
All right, let's see if this works. All right. So we're going to be talking about restaurant marketing today, how to get more business and increase your cash flow. And, you know, one of the things that I find interesting is the best way to do that is for a business to get into this mindset first about doing it. That's number one. Number two is we're going to talk about, you know, growing a customer list and how important that is to you. Because what we're finding here, I'm having problems going to the next screen, by the way. Can you just flip over to the next screen? There you go. So what we're going to cover today is building that customer list. Once you do that, what do you do with it? A lot of folks get stuck with this. You know, I'm building all this information, and your customer, once they join into any program that you have, they're adding their name to a list, whatever, they expect to receive something from you. So we'll talk a little bit about marketing automation, how that plays into this, and once you build that list, and then how do you use those things to increase your cash flow? So that you can get extra business from the little things that you're doing, like building that customer list, like building value to the customer, and more importantly, how to use special occasions and things of that nature to drive new business. Okay, so if you could go to the next slide.
Yeah, Dyson's going to talk about building your customer list, and this is what these guys do for sure. But before he gets into it, I just want to say that you're probably not doing this as a restaurant. Every restaurant I go to, 19 times out of 20, I'm not getting asked for my information, and it literally drives me crazy. And then when I do ask for information, then another 19 times out of 20, I don't actually get anything. So this is a huge miss for restaurants, and Dyson's going to talk about this. And I just wanted to chime in before that with my kind of frustration that restaurants aren't doing this enough. So what do you got? How do you talk about building a customer list? Why is it so important? Why should people make sure they have a database? And what do you think?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you're just like me, right? And our company, we all the time, I would say it's at least 8, maybe 9 out of 10 restaurateurs that we talk to, they really do miss this very important thing. I think a lot of restaurateurs should look at having a customer list like gold, right? Because it really is. These are people that are coming to your restaurant that are not, you know, casual consumers are not going to say, hey, I want to join your list, right? But the people that are coming to you that are enjoying your food, that enjoy your staff, that enjoy the surroundings and setting of your restaurant, these are the people you want in your list. These are the people that are going to join your list, right? And so let's talk about a list for a second, why it's so valuable. So you have these consumers coming to you, they get in a list, and this is why it's important. If your average, figure out what your average ticket is, and then look to get at least 10% of your customers that are coming to your restaurant and enjoying your food. You know, the loyal customer that you have, maybe it's a smaller percentage for the raving fans that you have and influencers, but these people, they get in your list. Now start thinking this way. If in a year's time, you go and get 4,000 people on your list, this is not hard to do, by the way, and we'll talk about that in a second. But they get on your list, and all of a sudden now, you know, let's say your average ticket's $40, and you have 4,000 people in your list, you have the potential as a restaurant to building and selling at least another $160,000. That's a really darn good reason to have a customer list. The smaller the number, you're still going to make money. But you have to start falling in love with this idea that I'm going to build a list of customers that are coming in and dining and enjoying my experiences here. So let's focus on that, right? So building this customer list is really easy, especially today. Today, as a restaurateur, businesses like ours have created technologies that make it so simple that you don't even have to think about doing it, that allows you to grow a customer list. So I'll give you a couple ideas. So the first one is like Wi-Fi marketing. It seems like every restaurant today is getting on that bandwagon to offer free Wi-Fi to the customer. And that's so that, you know, this is a great opportunity, right? So you take the food order, you have free Wi-Fi, obviously, server goes in the back, is keying it in the POS and tending to other customers. So your patron is probably going to be sitting there. They pull out their tablet, maybe they go and launch something for the kid. They give, you know, the tablet to their kid, and now they're playing something online, or you're checking scores, or you're checking your email. And this is why that Wi-Fi is so valuable. Well, the new technology, the new services that are available there for you allow you to capture customer content like their email address, like a Facebook page with demographic information like gender and birth date and stuff like that, and mobile numbers, and you don't even have to do anything. All you're doing is just using your existing Wi-Fi, and now all of a sudden you're capturing data. That's awesome. The other way that you could do it is, you know, today's tablets have the ability to run what's called kiosk mode. And that allows the tablet to be a data capture device. So now, you know, something like what we have a floor display stand that says, hey, enter in your mobile number, join the club, you know, sign up, whatever. And your customer is quickly going to enter in a 10-digit phone number. And that allows you to very easily get content. And then the last one is, all your customers have a mobile phone. That's how they're connecting to the guest Wi-Fi. That's how they're, you know, using that kiosk of yours. You might even offer them the ability just to text in your restaurant name to a short code, which is nothing more than a little phone number, and get content that way. So these are three very simple ways. And you don't even have to do anything as a restaurateur. You just need the technology.
And wait, so, guys, I can't believe how, no, listen, I was going to say, you know, do the infomercial stuff there, how easy it is. I mean, but it's interesting that you say that, because like, back in the day, if you think about, you know, collecting email addresses and putting them in a fishbowl and at the desk, and then someone has to type them in. And that's where I think the breakdown was, you know, fill out this form and type in your email address and hope that it makes its way back. But I do think that was still easy, by the way, and people, you should have done that, and you easily could have gotten the numbers you're talking about, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. Yeah. But what you just talked about, super simple with the tech. I mean, everybody, my kids, as soon as they sit down, do you have Wi-Fi? That's the only thing they're not nervous to ask about to adults. What's the Wi-Fi password, right? So they want the Wi-Fi, and I know adults do. People just are craving Wi-Fi, and you can use the technology to capture their data there. So that's a huge opportunity. Kiosk, super simple, and then text. Everybody, where's my phone? It's always right here, right? It's right here. It's, of course, it's right in front of me. So everyone has their phone with them all the time. And whenever I think about the phones, I think about back to the old idea of you know, fill out one page and you're capturing one email address. But when you have a four top of friends in, every four of them have phones, and now you can capture four people with a nice server introduction messages that's 30 seconds talking about some of the stuff we'll talk about, but email club, VIP club, birthday club, give them a nice message, and four people can go, oh shoot, boom. And then text in, like, and then literally in what, 7 seconds they're in. So it's real easy. So if you're not doing a database at your restaurant, you are missing out big time. It is easy and you have to do it. And if you're not doing it when this completes, and we're going to cover a whole bunch of tips, but definitely get this started today or tomorrow. Okay, so I know, let's keep moving. Let's talk about birthday stuff, which to me is a no-brainer, and you guys work this the magic with this. What do you got?
Yeah, this is magic, actually. It's ironic. A moment ago you said everybody has a cell phone. They certainly do, but to that point, everybody has a birthday too. Yes. Right. So if we go back one, I don't know how, but we just skipped ahead there. But so everybody has a birthday. Just think of this way. There's very few of your customers don't enjoy or love getting a birthday gift, right? Think of it this way. If you give, you get, right? So this is a fantastic opportunity for you to give something to your customers so that they are going to come back and bring friends, family, relatives, coworkers. So with that being said, a moment ago, we just talked about the birthday list, or customer list rather. This is a fantastic way for you to start growing that, as we just said. You know, you turn two tops into four tops, 6, 8, 10, 12, 20 guests for a birthday, right? And it's a proven fact that 7 out of 10 people go out on their birthdays or someone else's. So you get these your customer, they're already dining with you. The likeliness of them going out and eating on their birthday is extremely high. And if you don't have a customer list with the birthdays attached to it, guess what you're doing? You're missing out. You're losing business. So this is really simple. Put something in place very easily. Even if it's as simple as an Excel spreadsheet, you could do that. Or simply use our solution and we'll do it for you. But the best part about this is we know that birthdays are the number one event in your restaurant, bar none, right? So the great idea, everyone has one. You go and build this customer list real quickly using birthdays as the front and center and use special occasions to drive that business. So now, you know, to put something in front of your customer, don't do a coupon. I don't suggest a coupon whatsoever. I suggest that you give them a gift. You know, give them a free meal, for instance, $15. You know, you can have exceptions to this. Don't go crazy, but have an exception if you feel like, you know, you don't want to give the farm away, which I don't suggest you have to. Make it a big deal about your customer when they come there because they're going to be bringing other guests with them. You want to impress to those other guests to join in as well, right? So I would definitely, you know, treat your birthday guests like kings and queens. Get them an amazing experience.
Yeah, listen. I'm going to give my two cents on this as well. And it starts off with I did a session on birthdays a while back, but I think I took a screen capture of my screen at the time where I put off the different people that emailed me around my birthday, and it was like NBA.com and you know car dealership this and you know bank that. And zero restaurants, okay, and I was signed up for you know multiple restaurant lists, so I was ignored by the restaurants, and so as a customer, I would like you know we dine at a number of places regularly. I would like on my birthday to receive you know 3 to 5 offers, and I'm obviously may or may not be able to take advantage of all of them, but I would like to be recognized, right? So I would love to be getting these emails, and so I was gonna that's just one point. My second point is. You started to answer it there, but I wanted to ask you about the quality of the offer. Not like, hey, happy birthday, here's $5 off. Not strong enough, right? So I wanted you to elaborate on the strength of the offer a little bit, but also the timing and availability of the offer. It used to be, hey, you know, come in on your birthday and you get the thing. And of course, it's really hard to pull it off that day. It could be a Monday and it's just impossible, or it could be the weird day or whatever. I see a lot of people moving to the month of the birthday. Or 2 weeks. What do you recommend timing? And then what do you recommend strength of offer?
Yeah, I definitely recommend an entire month, mm-hmm. the birthday. The reason why we do that is because people are super busy, right? And you never know what friends and family have in plan or in mind for you on your birthday. This getting an offer, by the way, will and can shape where I'm going to go. Maybe I influence my friends and family to take me somewhere else, but do it for an entire month. That way it maintains value to the customer. You get a little bit more stretch to the opportunity as to how many people can come to you. And more importantly, it's going to work with their schedule. So that's I would definitely suggest at least the entire month. From there, I would also make sure that this is something valuable. Again, not a coupon, something valuable. So, you know, I see it drives me crazy. Restaurants will say, oh, have a piece of cake, right? Most people don't go out for cake on their birthday. Mm-hmm. People enjoy that in their home or in a family setting of some sort, but they will go out to dinner. So keep that in mind. When you build a birthday club, make sure that you're doing it with the heart of why they're coming and seeing you. Believe me, it's just as profitable for you to give a birthday meal as it is for you to give a birthday cake or slice or an appetizer. And the reason for that is because, yeah, an appetizer, your table's going to get one. Fantastic. Okay, great. But you want this to be about this customer. So make sure that it's going to be something. The reason why I came here is to eat. So nurture your customer's respect and word of mouth and use this as a great opportunity for you to grow goodwill, right? That's what I would do.
Yeah, listen, before we leave birthdays, I wanted to touch on this. You mentioned it earlier in your talk just a couple minutes ago, but if you realize that they're there for a birthday, and they may not know until the end when they're cashing this thing and or whatever, but as soon as you know that person is having a birthday, yeah, please make a big deal of it. It doesn't, and that does not necessarily mean 7 people coming to sing at the table, But you know, being happy and congratulations and happy birthday and maybe sharing with a few messages and so forth. I mean, like, make it a big deal. Like, they are there. They want to be treated special. I know some people are shy on my birthday. Some people in my family, no, don't tell them it's my birthday. So that happens too. But make it special. One touch that we had a restaurant do recently was a number of the servers signed a card. Very simple to do, right? And I don't know if they do this in advance or they did it when it happened, but they had a card. Thank you for coming in. And 6, 7, 8 people signed it. It was my daughter's in this case. Gave it to her. I thought that was a nice touch. And you could obviously include a bounce back in that as well. I don't think they did, but either way, nice touch. So opportunity there. Just last point here. Just this morning on Facebook, I saw a random post in a community group where I am. There was somebody looking for a nice special occasion restaurant. And just to your point, I forget if it was a birthday or an anniversary, but the point was they were bringing 20 people to this restaurant. Like, we're looking for a place to come with 20 people. And that's what people do on special occasions. They bring in 8, 10, 20 people, and you want to be in that consideration set. So let's keep rolling. We're going to talk about just overall customer appreciation and rewards. What do you got?
Yeah, so this is a biggie, right? So so far what we've talked about is building a customer list and how when you build that, that can easily start, you know, building repeatable business by 1-2 times. You know, I get that when I, there you go. So 1 or 2 times, right? Well, now you have this customer list. If you design a rewards program, this is for you to go in for recent, frequent, and the money that they spend in your business, you design a rewards program, you're going to start seeing that your customers come back 2 times more often than a regular customer. When they do that, part of your affinity, being part of what you're doing in your restaurant, being part of a club, and that feeling that I'm exclusive or VIP to your restaurant, these folks spend 4 times as much money than your everyday customer. Think about that person.
Clarification there for folks. When you say spend 4 times more money, you're not talking about in an individual visit necessarily, but maybe over
a year, for instance. Right. I mean, we find businesses that have a rewards program, you know, you can actually slow down on reaching outside to get new customers, number one, because you have these people that are coming back to you more frequent because they want to be rewarded. They want to be recognized. They want to feel like they're special and unique to your business. So you can have a couple of different things going. You can have like the everyday rewards. This is for every customer that comes in the door, right? You know, just go ahead and become part of the club. Then you can have this VIP. Then you can have this special customer. These are the things that you do to go and generate more business. By the way, you start doing this, rewarding your customers, you start bending their habits. So a lot of restaurants, including my aunts and uncles, we all believe that we have loyal customers. Of course you do. But they're not really loyal if you think about this, because if it's a steak, let's say you're a steakhouse, right? And do you get every single meal that they go out to eat as a steak when they're thinking about steak? No, you don't. You get some of them, but this is a better way to do it. You build rewards. So this goes back to building that customer database, knowing when your customer is coming and going. Give them bonuses based on thresholds. So for instance, here's an idea for you. Put something in place that says, hey, listen, you know, spend $250 and get a $20 reward. And don't just give it, you don't take that off a check, you just put it on their account and let them decide how they want to do it, right? Because you'll find that your customer, are going to come in more often. It gives you the ability to send promotions to this customer to drive and influence how often they're going to come here. So you're getting more of that lion's share of how often they visit or frequent your establishment. Here's the kicker. You do this, even if you do it badly, you know, let's say that you only get 5% of your customers, that could be an 80% increase in profits. That's amazing. Think about this. So your restaurant starts a rewards program. The restaurant dangling across the street doesn't have one. You will be 88% more profitable than they are simply because you have rewards. This is a great reason. It not only is it a great reason, but more importantly, it's a great way to increase the frequency and recency of your customer.
Yeah, Dyson, let me add on there that I do agree with you, and I do echo the fact that programs like that and like this can change the mindset of where to go. So for, you know, the example would be exactly that. Finally, we have the chance to go out to dinner. My wife and I, we got babysitting or whatever. Or even the whole family's going, or we have people in town. The point is you make that decision to go out to eat. Now, where do you go, right? So where do you go? Literally in my town, I know I have over 100 choices, but start to narrow it down, 50, 20. Maybe there's 10 places that I'm really deciding on tonight. Cuisine, price point, etc. So I still have a bunch of decisions. So who's going to get the dollars? Someone is going to get the dollars. And part of it might go down to, oh, I drove by and I saw them today, so they're in my head. Or part of it may go down to, I got an email reminder from them. I'm in their club. I know I have a balance. I know my next thing is I get a reward. I know I just got a text message. I've been communicated to. Those people are going to be more top of mind and have a better chance of me coming in. Then there could be a place that I love, but it's just not resonating that they're, and then when I finish, oh man, we should have went to Jim's Steakhouse, but I just forgot. I wasn't thinking about those guys. So you've got to be in their mindset. So that definitely is a process that goes through people's heads, where to go and how to choose that. And then you talked about bonuses and rewards, and I shopped with a retailer recently, and I kind of got lucky, but it happened to be one of their 3x points days. Right. Mm-hmm. So instead of just 1x points, it was a 3x. And so this was great. I spent more money that day, but I also got more rewards. And then I used those rewards almost right away. Within the next 2 weeks, I then bought more stuff because I had rewards points. So those things really do drive transactions. Any more parting thoughts on this?
Well, yeah, a lot, actually. So you're absolutely right. You know, using maybe it's your slower day or whatever to put in those reward multipliers. Mm-hmm. So it says to the customer, hey, listen, come here on Tuesdays because that's my slower day. And get 2x, 3x the reward just for dining with us. You can actually use higher priced menu items to wrap rewards around that. So if you're interested in, you know, focusing on growing your average check size, that's a fantastic way to do those things. It's also another way for you to spotlight items inside of your restaurant. So if you sell beer and wine and you want to, you know, wine's a very profitable item, so is beer, of course, so alcohol for that matter, period. But if you want to do those things, order, you know, that and get an additional reward, right? There's many different opportunities for you to use rewards to go and drive new behaviors inside of your business. And of course, a new behavior becomes habit. But one of the things that's also awesome about rewards is that's the best way that you can motivate people with word of mouth. I mean, think about this. I get something here, but I don't get it there, right? So now all of a sudden you become a better choice. And most likely, most of the people that are part of the rewards program are going to talk about the benefits and the value they receive from your restaurant as opposed to that one that doesn't have one. So this is a great reason, not just the financial reasons. There's, you know, the emotional reasons, and there's the psychological reason as well.
Yeah, listen, and just the last point here that I do like is people worry about discounting coupons. They don't want to be coupon centric. They don't want to be looked at as promotional, but people treat rewards exactly the opposite of that. They don't think about it as discount. They don't think about it as a cheap coupon that comes in I don't have one in front of me, but that comes in the mailer. It's a reward based on your behavior, and it's treated exactly different. Yes, they're getting a discount, but it's a different mentality. And if you're a mid-scale, upscale place and you don't want to be discounting, you can definitely be doing rewards, and it's a complete different mentality. So let's go to email marketing, which, my God, still exists in the world we live in today. So what is going on with email today?
Oh, yeah. So, you know, ironically, as you said, I mean, that it still exists. Ironically, it still is a very big driver for influencing your business, right? I'm going to tap backward for a moment there. But the email itself, everybody has an email address, and everybody still checks it. So the beautiful part about this is a great opportunity for you to use email. And if you're using it the right way, you can actually expand your business very quickly. As a matter of fact, one thing you want to use email marketing for is it's going to allow you to give, first off, lots of color. It's going to give you the ability to say a lot of different things and put your logo big and strong in front of a customer. We find that a lot of people that use email, they see return on investment of at least $36 to $51 per dollar you spend. So if you have a solution set like FanConnect, where you have the ability to send emails, that's fantastic. But you know what? If you're using a solution like FanConnect, the benefits that you're going to get here are a little, well, very different than what you would get from like maybe a Constant Contact, a MailChimp, something like that. And the reason why we say that, there's a difference between email marketing and emailing. And the difference is this. Every month has a commercial holiday, has an embedded holiday. And this is a great opportunity for you to communicate with the customer. And what we do for you is we put together 20 plus automations that allow you to talk to your customer frequently. That way you're maintaining that top of mind. That's really, really important because as you said a few moments ago, man, I could have eaten a great steak over at the steak joint. Well, you know, the reason why I didn't think of you is because you weren't top of mind. Mm-hmm. As a consumer, we find that most people only can remember six restaurants in 30 seconds that they go to. So The common question is, tonight, hon, where do you want to go and eat? I don't know. I don't know either. Well, what are you in the mood for? I don't know. Think about this. What if you were sending an email at least twice a month and influencing your customer to remember your business? That's why your business goes up and down like peaks and valleys, is because people don't, and we're really busy. We got work, we got the kids, we got this, we got that. I mean, there's all these things that are, you know, using, buying, changing our behaviors, changing our mindsets. People can't remember everything, and that's why you use email marketing to that benefit.
Yeah, no, for sure. Two things to pick up on there. One is frequency. You gave an example of two times a month, and I think that's certainly a solid recommendation. Once a month, I don't think is enough. And I personally don't have a problem getting an email once a week from a restaurant brand that I like. I've obviously signed up to get it. I don't want to see one every day. And retailers are bad at this. A lot of retailers will send you something every freaking day. Don't like that, but I certainly would like to hear from a restaurant on a frequent basis. The feedback that I've had and historically in the past is I don't have anything to say. You've addressed that a little bit by having, you know, kind of preset ideas ready to go, which I love. What else do you help restaurants do for messaging? Do you give them other tips? Hey, you know, yes, there's not a new menu item every day, but there's always something going on. To your point, there's invented holidays, you know, for one thing. But what other tips? How else do you build a marketing calendar? I know you kind of have a promotion schedule over here. How do they build that? How should they think about it?
Yeah, I think of it this way. So sometimes you don't have to invent very much of anything. If you think about this for a second. So a customer comes in, I come into your restaurant, Jamie, and you know, I eat, I like your food, I sign up for the you know, email club, whatever it is, I go about my business. It would be neat. Everybody loves a thank you. It shows an appreciation, right? That's a great opportunity for you to tell me about another menu item. Seriously. The other thing that you could do is you could talk about things that are going on around your town. And that gives you another reason to talk. The other thing you could do is you could talk about just funny things, right? You could even just send a puzzle to someone, a cool or funny YouTube video that you saw. You don't have to really reach very far to go and communicate with somebody. It's kind of like saying, oh, well, I haven't called you in a while because I have nothing to say. Well, sure you do. I mean, if this is a customer of yours, they're coming to enjoy your food. And if you don't know much about your restaurant yet, meaning in other words, you don't know what you stand for, you haven't really created this uniqueness about your brand, you don't you're not working on your brand as per se, you just have a restaurant and you're still going through that process to figure that out, that might be why you don't have something to say. But in general, every restaurant that has a brand has something to say. We have chefs from here, there, somewhere. We have a new employee. We have, you know, karaoke. We have this. We have that. Open mic. There's this happening in our community. You know, something happening with, you know, there are men and women that serve our country. Local government. Like I said, just that funny little comic strip. All we're doing is just saying, just maintaining a top of the mind. And it doesn't always have to have an offer. Sometimes it's just, hey.
Yeah, I agree. And especially in emails. Yeah, people, they get so bogged down and feeling like they don't want to be sell. So I do like the idea of looking for a community. I do like the idea of not everything has to be transactional, has to be selling, has to be a special offer. Do those things that Dyson's talking about. Just be a person, just be a member of a community, just be real, just do that aspect of it. And don't feel weird about sending emails that do those secondary things. It's not as about selling, but it will still keep you top of mind. So I did like that. The corollary would be the following. So in email, I think you have those opportunities that Dyson's talking about. It can be selling. It is colorful. It doesn't necessarily have to be immediacy based, but we're going to talk about I'll advance this, but mobile marketing, I think, is completely different. Mobile marketing is now, like when that thing beeps on my phone, I'm expecting it to be relevant to today. Is that factual? What do you think?
Oh my gosh. So mobile marketing, one of the newer opportunities on the scene here, when you're talking about marketing your business. But you know, yeah, everybody has a mobile phone. We keep it with ourselves, our person, 80% of the day, 22 hours a day, big screen, little screen. It's the screen we're most interested in. We look at it 150 times a day or more. So this is a place you want to be. You know, I remember years ago when the gift card first came on the scene, people were saying, oh, it's like a billboard in your wallet, right? This is a billboard in your hand. This is so amazing because you get color, you get text, you get all kinds of things that you can communicate to your customer, right? In bite-sized nuggets or full display. So you can use something as simple and powerful as a very short message, SMS, short message service. You could use that just to send a text message to somebody and say, hey, it's 3 p.m. Remember to dine at Dyson's Deli. That's not a coupon. That's just bending and shaping my mindset on a Thursday evening to come in and dine here. It's Friday. You know, where are we going to eat? Don't know. Well, if you get this message in their hands by 3 p.m., guess what's going to happen? You change where I'm going to eat. I wasn't thinking about steak. Well, now I am. I wasn't thinking about sushi. Now I am. You have lots of opportunities to do that. But you know what? Here's the other thing. If you think that everybody has a mobile phone, don't you think their friends and family have mobile phones too?
So what? If you want to grow, impossible. Okay.
Right, impossible. But if you want to go all the way back to the beginning of this conversation that we're having, we were talking about growing your list. When somebody receives an offer with FanConnect, you can actually use our viral share application and let them share it with their friends, family, Facebook, and there you go. You're unintentionally growing your customer data. And so that's really important. This is a great way to do it, and it's immediate. Right. So whether it's a small feature phone, there are some that have them. You know,
they do still exist.
I know. They're becoming popular all of a sudden. Nokia just came out with a new product line that's a flip phone. That's crazy. But or whether or not it's, you know, your beloved Apple device or Android device, you know, it really comes down to this is something that we hold all the time. It's in our pockets. It's in our purses. It's on our persons. And what better way? You send a text message and bing. That alert goes off, that notification goes off. And the first thing we do, we're looking, where's my phone? I have to find my phone because I have a message and I don't know who it's from. So the likeliness of it getting read is extremely high. As a matter of fact, it's like 97% of your messages. So you compare that to email. We're not going to say that email's not a good option here. Email's great when you need more to say. And you can actually combine the two, mobile and email, in the same thread to go and get the customer thinking about you, tap here to learn more, and now all of a sudden you're using both to accomplish using that short message and expanding on it, and whether or not you're using a coupon, whether or not you're just talking about an event, you know, those are the reasons why you do it. But here's the best thing. Again, it's the best way for you to start driving new business. Same store sales are extremely important to every restaurant on planet Earth. We're all very, very curious about how do I get repeatable business? How do I increase that repeatable business? This is it. Now, mobile marketing doesn't stop, by the way, on the handset, right? So we talked a few moments ago about capturing data through Wi-Fi and kiosks, right? So that's the reason why you want to do mobile marketing as well. It's easy, really easy for somebody to type in 10 digits as it is for somebody to fill in a comment card or go to your website and put in an email address. Think about that for a second. An email address is almost always longer than 10 digits. So this is really simple. If I want to join your Wi-Fi, most likely it's going to be from a mobile phone. As a matter of fact, we definitely have fact that it's at least 78% or more people access Wi-Fi using a mobile phone. So this is why you start considering mobile marketing for your business and how powerful it is. You know, I mean, you can reach your customers literally like that. I mean, it's just super simple and there's nothing like it.
Dyson, I first of all, I agree. And I wanted to just echo a couple of things. I mean, and this, I'm not going to say something that people don't know. The phone is not going away. I mean, just obviously people know this, right? Unfortunately, we have the zombie state of half of our population, but people are engaged to their phone. And when they hear that ping, man, they want it to be their phone. They don't want it to be their buddies who's sitting over there. That sounds like my ping. And they pick up that thing so quickly and they react to it very quickly. So it is, I mean, it's still special to receive a text message. People react to it. Are they going to come into your restaurant every time you send them a text message? Of course not, but you're going to be in that mindset that we've talked heavily about. So that for sure is true. It's only growing, very easy to do. People are very, yes, people protect their phone numbers, but they're, and we protect our email addresses, but we're willing to give them to retailers now. Now we're giving them a lot of times when we're checking out at various places just to get buzzed that my order's ready. So people are getting familiar with sharing it. So that used to be very taboo. I don't think that is the case anymore. And you can echo that if you wish. But the last thing here on this slide, the birthday thing with the banner and the kiosk, and we talked about birthdays earlier. This looks like a really quick, easy way. So I'm assuming that as a kiosk, boom, I hit a button and then the 10 digits thing that you're talking about and boom, I'm in. Is it that simple?
Oh my gosh, it's super simple. So first things first is this is one of our standard displays. It draws the eye very, very quickly. It could be designed for your restaurant or whatever, your logo, your colors, all that good stuff. And yeah, the customer just comes over, they tap that screen, they enter an 10-digit phone number. Here's the kicker. One of the things that we tell everybody is as soon as they enter the 10-digit phone number, we all know text messages are almost immediate, right? So why not use it to put a offer into their hands? It doesn't have to be right then and there. If you wanted to, you can stimulate more sales, but you can even follow it up the following day with a bounce back offer. Mm-hmm. So if you really want to drive sales, put that right in front of your host podium. They're not expensive. You know, you'll find, you know, what's expensive is if it doesn't work. So this, in my mind, has almost no expense because you put it in your restaurant. If you get 100 signups, guess what? You have the opportunity of making 100 sales within 7 days. So, you know, you really, if you're smart, maybe you take that bounce back offer, you make it 2 weeks, right? Yeah. And so I put in my mobile number, I get this offer that says, hey, I get a free appetizer, I get 50% off, a buy one, get one. Whatever it's going to be, just because I gave you my content. Remember, if you give, you'll get. Always remember that. And now you have them for the birthday club. So not only did I get their content, their mobile number, I pushed an offer to them, and now I also have your birthday information. And I have your email address too, yep. Because I can actually follow this up with another text that says, hey, if you give us your email address, we'll give you $5 off any $45 purchase. So you have all these opportunities of taking this very simple 10-digit phone number and turning it into gold, literally.
Yeah, back to the gold, back to that database. You need to be in control of your own database for your sanity, for your profits, and so forth. We've hit that pretty hard. So I'm going to keep going. This is probably a recap, right? Where we're talking about touch point marketing, all the different ways to do. What kind of tips would you have here?
Oh yeah. So, you know, when we first started this conversation, we said, you know, if we're going to grow a customer list, what do you do with it? As a consumer, I do expect that I'm going to get communications from you. These are great opportunities for you to maintain top of the mind, an offer, any offer, really. You know, come in and get a glass of wine with your dinner. You know, reds pair nicely with meats. Whites pair nicely with fish. You know, you don't have to be a connoisseur. Just get a glass, right? We miss you. That means I haven't seen you in a while. Right? This is an opportunity for you to wake the dead, right? Or that lost customer. Anniversaries, you know, I'm married, you're married, you know, a lot of folks out there are married, they have significant others, you know, why not invite them to share their anniversary with you? It's a perfect opportunity to go and have more than two people dining with you. Thank you. You know, that you say that, you instruct your staff to say that. Some of us are really good that when the customer leaves a door, you know, the restaurant, we hold open the door and we say, hey, thanks for coming. Why not turn that into electronic message as well? So you maintain that top of the mind, right? We talked a little bit about rewards. You make it rewarding that somebody gave you this content, and it's not just about driving a coupon offer. That's not what touchpoint marketing is all about. It's literally doing exactly what it says. Touch at a certain point when marketing. So it could be that holiday. It could be that invented holiday. It could be your holiday. Right? It could be your birthday at your restaurant, your anniversary at your restaurant. It could be a unique product that you just created. It could be a special event. Use those opportunities. The one thing that drives me really crazy, besides these customer lists and birthdays and everything else, is restaurateurs found to realize that we know people. They know people. We know people. So why wouldn't you use touchpoint marketing to generate new customers or new referrals? It's really easy to do. Right? The promotions, right? Promotions, again, do not need to be a coupon. It simply is, hey, I have a new menu item. Boo in the Park for Halloween. You know, that's happening over there. Why don't you come over here and eat before you go there? Events. There's many events, right? There's graduations. There's Mother's Day. There's this, there's that. There's all kinds of actual things that you can do to go and build on events. And even create your own, right? So these are just great examples of how you use touchpoint marketing to go and drive new business. But, you know, you get really busy. That's why you want to use a solution set like Fan Connect, where it's actually done for you.
Yeah, I want to chime in. If you were concerned that there's nothing to go on, nothing to message on, and we've already hit on that, just roll down the list that Dyson just rolled through. And there's like a litany of things to reach out to people on from basketball time, championship time, playoff time, this playoff time, that sports in your city, if that's a big deal, special events, charity events, fundraising, you know, politics, if you want to dip your toes in that comes up. There's so many things are going on that you need to be touching your customers. So yeah, I think about the doing it. And so, yeah, if we're talking about all these things and someone's going, oh crap, that's another 45 things I got to do. And I got to gather emails and I got to gather texts. And then I have to figure out how to message them and all that stuff. And it's really, yeah, you did have to do that years ago. I'll get you, but you don't. So the tech is there. So Dyson, roll through what you guys do to make this just, piece of cake. What do you think?
Oh, yeah. So, as a restaurateur, we get it. We understand that, like you just said a moment ago, I don't want one more thing to do, right? So we have a full service marketing solution. What we do is we set up everything for you, right? We designed our system so it's all about the customer and your restaurant, maintaining that top of the mind as we talked about, list building as we talked about. We provide you technology that makes it happen. And behind the scenes, we're basically your marketing department. So we focus highly on special occasion. I mean, because special occasion drives more tabletops than anything. So the birthdays, your anniversaries, Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, the holidays, we're going to drive that traffic for you. You don't even have to ask us to do it. We're just going to do it. Right? It's that simple. That way you don't have to remember to do these things. Last thing you're thinking, I guarantee you this, as a restaurateur, we're not thinking we get up, we shower, we get to the to a restaurant. The last thing that we're not thinking as we put that key in the door, we're not thinking, oh man, I have to market today, right? No, it's everything else. As Sally just called out, there's maybe that problem with the hood. It's, I got to go and get the daily specials done. I got to do this. I got to do that. I got to go and get in the vendor order and blah, blah, blah. There's so many things that we've got to do. Oh, and I have to remember to hire someone. I'm short staffed, mm-hmm. right? So the last thing you want to do is think about marketing. So let professionals like us that understand your customer, the customer, that's what we understand the most, how to go and put those butts in your seats, how to make it repeatable, and more importantly, how to take your restaurant and start building on your brand. If you haven't figured out what your brand is yet, let us work with you to help you drive that message so you start creating a brand. I mean, so many of us out there, have a small restaurant, 20 tables, 30 tables, but we still haven't decided yet what's our brand. I mean, we have a name. Okay, great. We serve, you know, we're a pizzeria with Italian food. There's lots of them. So what makes us unique? So using solutions like this, we can help you build a brand, build a culture, you know, build that rewards, build affinity for your business where people are all about your business and not someone else's, right? So you get this this marketing suite is what we call it, right? We're going to go manage this touch point marketing for you, winning back your lost customers, thanking your customers, driving the special occasion. We're going to do all the email marketing. You're never going to have to think of, oh my God, I don't know what to say. We'll do that for you. Okay. The mobile coupon and messaging, this is the easy part. We'll keep on putting your message in your customers' hands and asking them to drive new referrals for your business. And then getting that VIP program membership. We haven't talked about that. We'll go ahead and create a membership program for you so that you can actually get pre-sales inside of your restaurant. And that's so important. Why is it important? Because it just is. It's stretching your brand. It's getting people to pay today for something tomorrow. And it builds exclusivity. So if you're looking for all these things about different ways to do these things, you want to automate the engagement to your customer, you want to talk to your customer, you know, earlier we said that emails and text messages, maybe 2 times a month that we talk to them, really you can get away with 3 times, right? Thank you, we miss you, and message. Those are great drivers to building your business. So all these things, we have a solution for you. You know, it's very affordable. When you think about it, you not doing this is a disaster. It just is, because somebody else is going to start doing it. And that means that this could be the difference between success or failure, right? So we really want to pay attention to having, you know, services like this in a restaurant. It's like a system, right? You have systems to go and cook. You have systems to go and, you know, run your restaurant. We have systems for how we open and close. You need a system to how to engage your customer. And that's exactly what we supply.
Yeah, that's funny you said that. When I look down, I'm usually jotting something. So that's the word that I just wrote down was systems, for folks, because the example you gave of the dude walking in and Sally called out and you know you've got to hire somebody and all that stuff happens as soon as it hits you. So you're putting out fires, and so you don't actually sit down and build a promotional marketing schedule because you can't. A lot of times you don't have the time to do that. So you need to have the system in place that is collecting the data all the time. Customers are coming in, they're getting their mobile phones, and this stuff is just happening. And then it's building on itself in this virtual cycle. As more people come in, more people join a club, more people have a chance to get rewards, more people have a chance. So that's why I'm really passionate about this as a way to drive your business. I see too many restaurants struggling on the revenue side, right? You can, the whole argument of, you know, revenue makes all problems goes away. Obviously you have to manage your costs, mm-hmm. so forth. But if you don't have people coming in the door, you don't have an opportunity to manage costs and you're going out of business, which is not what we want to see here. So I really like this piece of it to be maximized and working well. And so I like the stuff you're talking about. As we're starting to wrap here, there's a couple more slides. We've covered a lot. How do you start to wrap up this process? Certainly hit a lot of benefits already.
Yeah. So just remember what we're proposing here to you, what we're talking about here is how, most importantly, get that customer retention model in place. This is really, and when we're talking about this, when we're talking about repeat business, loyalty, rewards, that's exactly what we're talking about. Customer retention. How do I keep my customer coming back? How do I build the frequency? And when I do those things, what do I get out of it? Right? So top of mind for a restaurateur, you know, is how do I build customer retention? From here, we do those things. This is where you get the sweet spot, right? I retain my customers, therefore I'm going to get more sales. I get more revenue, right? That's what we're looking at. We're looking at how do we build opportunity in our restaurant using these services and these type facilities so that my restaurant is on the winning side of the fence and not, you know, we're not struggling anymore. So again, it's building that customer list, making sure that we're motivating that increased visit. You're going to boost your loyalty, the frequency of your customer by doing these things. And then, of course, you make the case for your customer to buy. Okay? So, I mean, that's really the value proposition that you're talking about here.
Yeah, Dyson. Last thing here. So on the revenue side, what can you share? Without giving people's names, giving numbers, giving things like that. Everybody wants to know: is it going to work for me? What am I going to get out of it? What do you think is some ideas? What's some benchmarks people could look at when they put systems in place? What do you think?
Now, so here's the thing. If you grow your customer list and you're just doing the subtle things that we've talked about, you increase your business by 88%. Simple. Okay. That's number one. At least your profits, because it's going to cost you less to get that new customer in the door. It's going to cost you less to go and figure out how to drive new business. It's going to cost you, less because you're training new staff, because you don't have turnover in your restaurant, so you're losing them. So those are the where you're going to shave those costs. Where you start making money is because you engage your customer four times a month or more, depending on how you're doing things. You know, the thank yous, we miss yous, holidays, birthdays, all these things. Now all of a sudden, these are more profitable opportunities. A birthday party is going to generate at least $87 per ticket or more, right? At least. So, a lot of restaurants that we talk to have ticket sizes between 30s and 40s, right? Well, if you're doubling your income and you have a program like this, it doesn't take much or long for you to exceed the value of these programs. So all of a sudden, now you're on the winning side of the fence. You're profitable. Reactivating a lost customer, man, I can't say enough about that. So every restaurant on an annual basis loses about 20% of their customer base. They die. They move away. If you move 5 miles away from a restaurant, it's like you're on another planet.
Yeah.
So, you have to have ways that you are generating and making up for those losses. And you have to do it with a system in place that makes it possible for you. So not having a system like this is costing you dearly every day of the week, not having a system like this. So it's really important. Get on the bandwagon now and start doing it.
Yeah. So closing thoughts, last couple minutes here as we get into it. If you were to wrap up, you're talking about, building the list faster, automating stuff, any other, you've hit them with a lot, but any other last thoughts?
Just do it. I don't want to sound like Nike or anything, but yeah, the last thought is don't just listen to this, ladies and gentlemen. Honestly, if it's us, fantastic. We welcome you. We'd love to work with you. Don't make mistakes just by, not saying this isn't for me and I don't think this would work for me and things. Of course it would. What's so different about your restaurant that's different from another person's restaurant besides the food, the ambience, and you? Everything else is the same. It's the same customer. So think about it that way. Don't worry about it's my brand. Will my brand warrant this or that? The other thing, if you have customers, you need this, period.
Yeah. Yeah, listen, I agree. I'm super. That's why I brought Dyson on, and I'm as I led with, and I'll finish with. I'm super believer in this stuff. Big believer in the marketing systems. They have to be in place these days to compete. If you're not doing these things, as Dyson talked about, your competition is doing them, and you're losing one visit, and you're losing me, and you're losing Tina. And all these other folks are slowly drifting off. Is there a new restaurant opening in your town? Yeah, there probably is, right? So what are you doing to combat the pull that those dudes are having? And then the chains are doing this. And then, so you've got to be active. You cannot be quiet. So I'm such a big believer in this. We've actually partnered with Dyson and his company to bring these marketing resources to my members and my readers. And not just like in a way like, hey, go check out Dyson's site. He's great. It's not like that. Running restaurants is going to actually participate along with Dyson to give you more marketing resources. We're going to be vested in your success. And so we want to work with you and support you to get these things into your restaurant if you're not using them. And maybe you don't talk to us at all, but you've got make sure you get this stuff into your system. So if this sounds good, if the stuff that Dyson has talked about is interesting for your restaurant, and I hope that it is. So what I want you to do is reach out to me, reach out to Dyson. Our emails are on the screen, dyson.barnett@getfanconnect.com and jamie@runningrestaurants.com. All you got to do is reach out to us. Say you watch this webinar where we talked about a lot of stuff. You want to learn more because it sounds interesting. And what we're going to do is we're going to do something special for a limited number of folks that have watched this, and sort of the whole, you know, almost like Black Friday, you know, click here to see the price of the card. Where we're not going to show you the price, but because it's going to be such an incredible offer that we're not going to put it on the screen for you, but you've got to reach out to us and we're going to put this stuff together for you in a package that includes Dyson stuff, as well as marketing resources from running restaurants, as well as some special content that you're not going to be able to get anywhere else that's going to drive and really crush it for you. So if you want to do that, reach out to us. I think that's all I had to say. Any last parting thoughts, Dyson?
No, man, you did great. Thanks again for being partnered with us, and certainly look forward to helping a lot of restaurateurs that are partnered with you as well.
Yeah, yes, sir. I do as well. So please reach out to us. We want to get you started. We want to get you kicking butt and so forth. So folks, that was Dyson Barnett, CEO of FanConnect. Their marketing systems will absolutely rock your restaurant results. So make sure you reach out to them or me as soon as possible, and we'll get this particular special going for you. Only a limited number of folks we can do this for. So again, reach out to Dyson at dyson.barnett@getfanconnect.com or me, Jamie, at runningrestaurants.com, or just find the website. You can find me. We're out there. So reach us, talk about this webinar, tell us you want to learn more. We're looking forward to working with you and your restaurant, and we wish you all the success. So thanks again for joining us. We'll see you again soon.
Take care.